Hi everyone, welcome back. So we were discussing about electromagnetism. Today we will be going to learn about current carrying conductors. Okay, current carrying, what we came to know that current carrying conductors produces what? Current carrying conductor produces magnetic field. That's what we have seen. Current carrying conductors produces magnetic field. So here in this case, we will be considering three cases. First one is our straight wire carrying current. Second one will be considered our coil. In the coil, what is the direction of the magnetic field? Third one will be considering about our solenoid. So these are three things that today we'll be going to discuss. That is our straight wire carrying current, coil, and third one will be our solenoid. Let's see the first one, straight wire carrying current. So what is the direction of the magnetic field if the current is passing through a straight wire? Okay, let's see. So first one, straight wire carrying current. Okay, for that purpose, what we will do? We will take consider one table. Okay, and at the end of the table, what we will do? We will place one wooden piece. Okay, which have a hole at one end. Understood? We'll be considering one wooden piece which have a hole at one end of the wooden piece. I will draw it a little bit bigger so that you can understand very clearly. So this is our wooden piece which have a hole at the center. So at the other end of the wooden piece, what we will do? We will fix one retort stand. So what we will do? We will consider one line and one wire. We'll consider one wire and we will send that wire through the. Okay, we will consider one wire and we will send that wire through the hole. Okay, and those two ends of the conductor is connected to what? It is connected to a source. Okay, it is connected to a source. Now what we will do? We will take few magnetic needles and we will place randomly at what the near to the hole. Okay, we will take few magnetic needles and we will place it near to that hole. Now what we will do? We will switch on the supply AC source. When we switch on the AC source, what we can observe that the current starts passing through the conductor. When the current starts passing through the conductor, we already came to know that current carrying conductor produces magnetic field. Due to that magnetic field, what we can observe that whatever the needles that we have kept in different directions, all these needles will form into a circular shape. So what this tells about, if all the needles are forming a circular shape, means what? Due to what this needle formed a circular shape is nothing but due to it what? Due to the magnetic field, this magnetic field made this needles to form into a circular shape. With this, what we can understand that magnetic field, whatever the magnetic field is, a magnetic field shape is what? Magnetic field shape is a circular shape. So what we have understood that whatever the magnetic field that you are observing that forms in the form of what? That magnetic field will form into a circular shape. So what is the shape of the magnetic field? We can say it as a concentric circles. Okay. Concentric circles or a circular shape, that is the shape of the magnetic field. Here what we can understand that we have got two concepts here. What is one is into the page and other one is out of the page. What is into the page and what is out of the page? Let us see now. What is this into the page? First thing, into the page, or it is also called, we can use the rule called as Maxwell's corkscrew rule, or into the page or out of page. Now here what we will do, as we are considering one screw will have a cross sign. So when we are inserting the screw into the table, what we can observe that how you'll be inserting it, you will be inserting in a clockwise directions, right? So here think that the whatever the cross line you are observing here, it is our conductor, means not the conductor, current. Okay. Around the current, what we have understood that when current is passing through a conductor, a magnetic field will be generated around the conductor. Now here, this cross line says about what? Into the page. What is into the page? Current is into the page. Okay. If the current is into the page, then what will be the direction of the magnetic field? As I said, into the page means what? You are inserting the screw into the page. In which direction will be inserting? You will be rotating in the clockwise direction. So here what we can say that the direction of the magnetic field will be what? Will be clockwise direction. Okay, what will be clockwise direction? Magnetic field. When the direction of the magnetic field will be clockwise direction, when the direction of the current is into the page, then the direction of the magnetic field is what? Clockwise direction. Okay, next one is what? Out of page. Okay, out of page means what? When the current is out of page. Out of page is denoted with a symbol dot sign. Okay. If it is dot sign means what? The current is out of page. Now what will be the direction of the magnetic field? Out of page means you are removing out from the object, the screw. So in which direction you want to remove the screw from the, in which direction you will be rotating to remove the screw from the object? We will be rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. So here, if the current is out of page, the direction of the magnetic field will be what? Anti-clockwise direction. Okay, what is that? Anti-clockwise direction. What is anti-clockwise direction? Magnetic field will be anti-clockwise direction. So here into the page is also called as what? Downward direction. When the current is in downward direction, then the magnetic field will be what? Magnetic field will be clockwise direction. When the current is in upward direction, when the current is upward direction in the conductor, then the direction of the magnetic field will be what? Anti-clockwise direction. Understood everyone? So here what is the rule we'll be using here? Here you can use the Maxwell's screw rule, and otherwise you can also use the right hand thumb rule. What does this right hand thumb rule tell us about? Right hand thumb rule. So here if you observe the right hand thumb rule, you will be placing the hand in this way. Here the thumb will tell us about what? The thumb will tell us about the direction of the current. Okay, thumb will tell us about the direction of the current, and all the curved fingers will tell us about the direction of the magnetic field. Understood? So for a straight wire carrying current, what is the rule will be used here? Right hand thumb rule. Here thumb will tell us about what? Thumb will tell us about the direction of the current, and whatever the remaining four fingers are, it will tell us about the direction of the magnetic field. And we also came to know about what is the Maxwell's screw rule. So here if the current is into the page or downward direction, then direction of the magnetic field will be clockwise direction. If the current is out of page or upward direction, then direction of the magnetic field will be what? Anti-clockwise direction. Understood up to here? That is about what? Our straight wire carrying current. That is our first one. Next one is what? Our coil. Next one is our coil. Now, so what we will do, we will take one wooden block and we will make two holes, and through the holes what we will do, we will pass the conductor, maybe 4 to 5 winding we will do. We will pass 4 to 5 wires around the wooden piece through the hose. Okay, when 4 to 5 wires of our conductor passing through, it looks like a coil. Okay, coil. Now what you will do, you will take one magnetic compass and you will place the magnetic compass below the wire in such a direction that the needle of the magnetic compass is along the direction of the coil. Okay, you place the compass in such a way that the needle of the magnetic compass is along the direction of what? Along the direction of the coil. Now the ends of the coil is what? Ends of the coil is connected to our AC source. When we switch on the AC source, what we can observe that whatever the needle which was along the direction of the magnetic field, it will changes its direction to what? It will change its direction to perpendicular direction. So this is our magnetic compass. So what it will do? It will changes its needle will change into what? Perpendicular direction when it is connected to the source. When it is connected to the source, what will happen? The current start passing through the conductor. When current passing through the conductor, what will happen? A magnetic field will be generated around the conductor. Due to that magnetic field, what will be the deflection of the needle? The deflection of the needle will be perpendicular to the magnetic field. With this, what we can understand that in the coil, what we have understood that in the coil, the magnetic field will be what? Magnetic field will be perpendicular to the what? Perpendicular to the plane of the coil. Okay, this is the plane of the coil. And what will be the direction of the magnetic field? Direction of the magnetic field will be perpendicular. Okay, now what is the rule? We'll be using the right hand thumb rule. Okay. Now what is right hand thumb rule tells about? Here it is a little difference between there for the straight wire and the coil. In the straight wire, what we have done, thumb denotes the direction of the current, and all the remaining curved fingers will tell us about the direction of the magnetic field. But here in this coil, it will be reverse. Here thumb will tell us about what? The thumb will tell us about the direction of magnetic field, direction of the magnetic field, and remaining curved fingers will tell us about the direction of the current. Okay, understood the differences? In a straight wire carrying current, thumb will tell us about the direction of the current, remaining curved fingers will tell us about the direction of the magnetic field. Coming to the coil, in right hand thumb rule, thumb will tell us about what? Direction of the magnetic field, and all the remaining curved fingers will tell us about the direction of the current. Understood everyone? So here, what we can understand that if the direction of the magnetic field is pointing towards you, now if you observe the remaining fingers direction, it will be anti-clockwise direction. So what we can understand here, first point, that if the direction of the magnetic field is pointing towards you, what we can understand that direction of the current will be what? Direction pointing towards you means what is the direction of the current? Direction of the current will be anti-clockwise direction. Second point is what? If the direction of the current is pointing away from you, if you observe here, the direction of the current is what? Direction of the current, it will be clockwise direction. So if the direction of the magnetic field, is pointing away from you, so what will be the direction of the current? Direction of the current will be clockwise direction. So that is the important difference between the direction of the current. If the direction of the magnetic field is towards you, the direction of the current will be anti-clockwise direction. If the direction of the magnetic field is pointing away from you, and direction of the current will be what? Direction of the current will be clockwise direction. Understood everyone? That is about our coil. Okay, what we have understood in the coil, magnetic field will be always perpendicular to the plane of the coil when the coil is connected to a source. Okay. Next one is our solenoid. So what is that next one? Next one is our what? Next one is our solenoid. Now what is a solenoid? If you take a coil, coil means what? A wire winded. Okay, in a circular shape. It's called spiral shape. It is called as a coil. Okay. If a wire is winded in the form of a spiral shape, it is called as a coil. So a solenoid is nothing but a long coil. A long coil is called as a solenoid. So what will be the shape? You can say it is a spiral shape, spiral in shape, because a long coil. If you take a coil and if you wound it in this very spiral shape or a long wire, it is called as what? A solenoid. Solenoid is what? It's a long wire. It is spherical in shape, spiral in shape. What is the next one? It is what? It is a closed packed helix. Helix means what? It's a spiral in shape. The closed packed helix. Now next one. Think that this is our solenoid. Okay, this is our solenoid. When a current is passing through the conductor, coil or solenoid, what we can observe that a magnetic field will be generated around it. Now, if you observe the direction or the property of the magnetic field, it looks similar to the direction of the magnetic field which we can observe in the bar magnet. In the bar magnet. So, what we can say that solenoid will act as what? Will act as a bar magnet. Solenoid will act as a bar magnet. Okay. And the direction of the magnetic field outside the solenoid will be what? Outside the solenoid, direction of the magnetic field will be north to south. North to south. This is north pole and this is south pole. Direction of the magnetic field outside the bar magnet, outside the solenoid will be what? North to south. And inside the solenoid, its direction will be south to north. Inside. So from north to south, it will be passing, and after that, what will happen? It will enter into the coil or solenoid. So what will be its direction of the magnetic field? It will be north to south. Next, coming to the magnetic field property, the magnetic field outside will be what? Outside of the solenoid will be non-uniform, because at some region it is becoming crowded, at some region becoming apart. So what we can say that outside the solenoid is magnetic field will be what? Non-uniform, but inside the solenoid it will be uniform. Why it will be uniform? If you observe here, inside the solenoid all will act as what? Parallel lines, parallel field lines. So since it is parallel field lines, means what? It is uniform. So what we can understand that inside the solenoid the magnetic field lines will be uniform, outside the solenoid magnetic field will be non-uniform. Outside it moves from north to south, and inside it moves from south to north. Understood. So it is a long coil. Its shape is what? Its shape is spiral in shape, and it is a closed pack helix. It acts as a bar magnet because it looks similar to the bar magnet. And if you observe the magnetic field, it will be what? It will be moving from left to right or north pole to south pole outside the solenoid, and therefore inside the solenoid, magnetic field will move from south to north. Okay. And coming to the magnetic field, outside the magnetic field it will be non-uniform. Inside the magnetic field it will be uniform. So this is about our solenoid. So here also same rule, right hand thumb rule. We'll follow the right hand thumb rule. Okay, as that of coil, what we have seen, same rule will be used here, right hand thumb rule. Okay, understood about solenoid. So with this, what we have understood that first thing is what? Current carrying conductor produces magnetic field. Current means what? Nothing but motion of charge. Okay. When charge moves, then only current is generated. If current is producing magnetic field, means what we can understand that charges also produces magnetic field. So motion of the charges also produces magnetic field. So these are the three things what we have learned. First one is a straight wire carrying current. Second one is a coil, and third one is our solenoid. Thank you.